Hello and welcome to Coco Styling. This is going to be a short video. It's just to explain the difference between a spoon body type and the pear body type. Pear is the most common female body shape. This might be why sometimes it is divided into different categories or use different names. I have seen pear, triangle, spoon, figure 8, and even mango. There can be visible differences between a pear, a spoon, and a mango, but I think the core idea is the same. They are the body types in which their lower half carries the most visual volume. This means their hips and or bottom looks larger in comparison to the rest of their bodies. The difference between all of them sits in how exaggerated their proportions might be. But you will use the same principles to style them. Minimize the volume on the lower half and add volume to the upper half. Spoon or figure 8. Your waist to hip ratio is larger than regular pears, usually more than 10 inches or 25 centimeters. Their hips have a shelf-like appearance because their wider part tends to be the upper part of the hips and not the lower one. They might have larger busts, but still, their bust measurement is smaller than the hips. It's also very common for spoons and figure eights to have hip dips or violin hips. How to style the spoon body shape? Emphasize your narrow waist, define your bust, add volume to your shoulders, and reduce the attention from your hips. Styling a spoon is like styling a pear, but here are a few things you can keep in mind. Avoid details on both your lower and upper hip. Instead, try bottoms with front or back details. Peplum tops can be tricky, because they usually have ruffles on the waist, and that will mark your waist even more. But if the ruffles are too long or stiff, they can widen your upper hip, and you don't want to add volume there. Choose flowy and drapey peplum tops instead of stiff peplum tops. If you have larger breasts, add volume to your shoulder instead of adding it to your bust. Another thing you can do is to try to widen your upper half with upper sleeve details and off-shoulder tops. Your best necklines will be boat neck, sweetheart, wide V, and U-neck. Tops that gently flow below your waist but don't add volume to your hips are very flattering. Make sure your bottoms fit you well. Depending on how exaggerated your features are, you might have to get them tailored. Make sure they fit well on your hips and then tailor your waist. Choose bottoms that de-emphasize your lower half. Also, avoid big details on the sides like big pockets. Flared trousers are not the best option. Instead, you can try straight cut or wide-legged pants. Wide waistbands are great for many reasons. They can hide bulges, make your legs appear longer, and they also define your waist. For swimwear, you should apply the same principles as pears, and other things you can apply to the spoon body type are: you should wear a bold top and minimalistic bottoms. If you want to wear different colors, your bottoms should be darker. Scooped and bead bottoms can create the illusion of having narrower hips. If you want to wear tankinis, make sure they have bust embellishments. These are all of my styling tips for pear variations. As you can see, they're very similar to pears, and you just have to keep in mind these small differences if you want to look your best. Another announcement I wanted to make is that the giveaway post and the rules will be up tomorrow. Make sure you follow me on both Instagram and YouTube so you don't miss it. Have a nice day, and I hope to see you soon!